Hello, this is Pilot Rick. This adventure took me to Reading, Pennsylvania, to attend the Mid-Atlantic Aviation Museum's World War II Reenactment Weekend. This and several other of my videos can be seen on my YouTube channel, Big Adventures in Small Planes. I recently learned about this event and discovered that this year is the 33rd annual airshow, and I thought it would make for a nice long weekend adventure. Here I am packing the plane. And pulling the plane out of the hangar. Ready to go and starting up. There I am in the yellow circle, taking off from Ohio State. This is the first leg of my weekend journey, taking me to Latrobe, Pennsylvania for a fuel and lunch stop. A typically convenient self-service fuel island. not far from the FBO and the restaurant. Air Elite did not charge me a parking fee since I bought fuel. It's a short walk from the FBO across the parking lot to the main terminal where the restaurant is. The Nunzio's restaurant is on the second floor with a wonderful view of the runway. The food is plentiful and very good, but a little bit on the pricey side. From the outside balcony of the restaurant, you can see my plane parked outside the FBO. The next portion of my trip was from La Trobe all the way to Reading, Pennsylvania. I was on an IFR flight plan, dodging the scattered clouds along the way. Reading Aviation Line service guy immediately met me on the ramp and parked my airplane. My hotel was a very short walk from the FBO, and as it turned out, the shuttle stop taking me into the airshow grounds was right outside the hotel. As you can see from the picture, this PT-22 is from Visalia, California, and I have family in that area, so I had to take a picture of this airplane. This C-53, also known as a DC-3, Beach City Baby, was sitting on the grass field of Beach City Airport in Ohio, 2 Delta 7, for many years. Until finally, airline pilot Jason Capra discovered it and headed up a group who restored it to flying condition. It now participates in various air shows throughout the year. Here is an unusual Cessna. I took this picture because I fly a Cessna. Here is a group of historians reenacting as officers from World War II, describing events in the Pacific. These were among the 12 World War II veterans in attendance. There were over 1,250 reenactors at this event, over 250 World War II vehicles, including many tanks, and hundreds of tents throughout the grounds. This group of reenactors participated in a skirmish with the Germans in this mock-up of a French village, which I'll show you next. There was a mechanized infantry battle in the infield of the airport. There were many reenactors in many tents. There was a great variety of airplanes in the air show. Over 80 aircraft participated. Even the B-29 Fifi participated in the air show. This is one of only two B-29s still flying. Both Friday and Saturday nights, there were meals that you could purchase ahead of time. Here's my chicken dinner Saturday night. It was wonderful. A whole half of a chicken. I was stuffed. I bought a ride on this PT-19 with pilot Mike Kunert. Mike has owned this plane for about 15 years, and in that time has flown it over 3,500 hours. If you see a PT-19 in the movies, undoubtedly it's Mike flying it. He even let me fly the plane for about 12 minutes. leaving Reading, my first stop was at the Northumberland County Airport, November 79, for cheap fuel for my return trip. After refueling, I took off heading for Ohio. I flew IFR because of the cloud cover and had more than a 40 knot headwind at 10,000 feet. I finally made it to Washington Courthouse, Ohio, and filled up with cheap fuel before flying to my home base. Here I am, tucked safely back into my hangar at Ohio State. My next adventure trip will be to fly up to AirVenture Oshkosh this summer. Look for that video in a few weeks. I hope you enjoyed this adventure trip. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. Keep the shiny side up and the pointy end forward. Wishing you blue skies and tailwind.